Welcome to the Learn Kubernetes with Google video series. My name is Sarvesh Rangnekar, and I'm a software engineer at Google. In this episode, I'll be demoing two popular Kubernetes network models, the island mode network model and the flat mode network model. This video is a follow-up to the last video in the series by Chris, where he explained the details of how the two models function. I'll be diving into details about how to configure the two models on Anthos BareMetal, and discuss the differences between the two using live Anthos BareMetal clusters. So let's dive into it with island mode. Currently, island mode is the default mode for IPv4 workloads on Anthos BareMetal. A quick start link for Anthos BareMetal cluster setup is added in the description below. Once you reach the step named edit the config file, for the cluster network section in cluster spec, you need to provide pod ciders for the cluster. You may reuse the same pod cider across multiple clusters. This is especially useful for IPv4, as you might not have the luxury of a large IP address space. As seen in this example, the pod cider configured for cluster 1 is 192.168.0.0/16. And the same pod cider can be used for any other cluster, say cluster 2. Without worrying about any kind of side effects. This is possible because the packet is SNAT translated with the IP address of the node where the pod is running. That is, the pod IP remains private within the cluster, and the traffic going out of the cluster appears to be coming from the node on which the pod is running. Let's look at a cluster running in island mode. We have already created some Nginx pods in island mode cluster. As you can see, the pod IP 192.168.3.116 comes from the pod cider configured in the cluster spec. And for island mode, the same pod IP can exist in another cluster. We will now exec into a pod and ping an IP of a machine which is not in the cluster. We are running a TCP dump on that machine in the window bottom. Let's exec into the pod. Okay, so we are getting a few pings. Let's see. So we are getting ping from an IP address 210.208.66, but the pod IP was 192.something. So where is this IP coming from? So as you can see, it's an IP address of a node on which the pod is running, which was N103. So for island mode, as you can see, it's not coming from the pod, but it's coming from the node IP. Now we'll discuss more about flat mode. For enabling flat mode on Anthos BareMetal, some modifications are needed. These modifications will be done in the cluster config file under the cluster network section. First, we need to specify flat IPv4 to be true. This specifies the intent to use the flat mode network model. Second, remove the pod ciders field from the cluster network. This field is not used when flat IP is enabled. Third, in the same cluster config file, append a cluster cider config spec. This provides the pod cider for the cluster. As opposed to the island mode, the flat mode pod cider configured in the cluster cider config needs to be unique and must not overlap with any other range, such as node IPs being used in the network. Just like the nodes in the cluster, in flat mode, the pods are just another endpoints and are externally visible and routable. We have already created some Nginx pods in the flat mode cluster. As you can see, the pod IP 21.251.191 comes from the pod cider configured in the cluster cider config. And for flat mode, the pod IP must be unique across clusters. We will now exec into a pod and ping an IP of a machine which is not in the cluster. Let's see on the external machine what IP the packet comes from. As we can see, the packet is coming from 21.251.191, which was the pod IP. And it is not NATed with the node's IP. So in this video, we looked at how to configure different network models on Anthos BareMetal, and saw the difference between island and flat mode on live Anthos BareMetal clusters. Thanks for watching Learn Kubernetes with Google.